I kinda can't believe that this video needs to be made, because these seat problems can and should be repaired with one $20 part and a 30-minute mobile service appointment. Unfortunately, and strangely, Tesla service centers often don't know how to diagnose this. It won't take you long on Google to find person after person who has paid $3,000 to have Tesla take a week to replace their entire seat. When I discovered how easy this is to fix, and I mean really easy, I was happy to save myself a few thousand dollars, but at the same time felt like I needed to let owners, and I guess service centers, know how to diagnose and fix this easily. Let's look at the symptom where the seat won't slide for easy entry. You hit the easy entry button, the seat reclines halfway as it should, but the track doesn't unlock and you can't slide the seat forward to get out. The seat is just locked to the slider track. There are plenty of examples online of people facing this problem. This poor guy had his entire seat replaced once under warranty and then less than a year later is dealing with the same problem again, but this time after the warranty expired. Now the symptom where the seat won't latch to the track. This was what happened to my car. You may or may not have a dashboard error. Again, plenty of people dealing with this, and each of them encounter some form of, quote, Tesla looked at it for 2 minutes, shrugged, and said we need to replace the seat for $3,000. One person figured out a clever way to use a piece of 3/4 ply to prevent the seat from sliding. This video walks you through the diagnosis and repair, and also takes a look at how and why this part keeps failing. So let's dig in. Getting the seat back unzipped and exposing the innards of the seat is fairly straightforward. Some needle-nose pliers should help with the zipper pulls. We're looking to gain access to this actuator here. This is the track release actuator. Now, depending on your symptom, this actuator has either failed like mine and bound up after pulling the cable, in which case your seat won't latch to the slider, or it is failing to pull the cable, in which case it doesn't unlock the track for easy entry. Either way, we can diagnose whether this is electrical or mechanical by opening the actuator and pulling the cable ourselves. Here I unplug the motor and dive in. You can kind of see that there's latent tension pulling that white plastic gear up. After taking the gears out of the puck housing and releasing that tension, I have actually relatched the track and fixed the problem where the seat just slides around. In fact, with the actuator unplugged and taken apart, we have now turned this problem into the other one, where the seat won't slide at all when using the easy entry button. Yeah, a bunch of broken gears. Why did these gears get so destroyed? Let's take a peek under the cover. Looking at the pull cycle, I can definitely hear the motor straining. This is a lot of force through plastic gears. But there's no smoking gun. Let's look at the return cycle. In this case, the track release springs are going to be pulling on the cable and the motor will be running too. There could be a lot of momentum here. When that white spindle pulling the cable encounters the stop, there's a huge collision. The whole puck shudders. On my car, this actually stripped the top screw out of its hole. I'm not sure how many cycles of this these plastic gears can take. Now, let's fully finish our diagnosis by manually operating this actuator. Grab your helpers. Now check that the seat is latched. Great. Now let's pull the cable ourselves, making sure that the plastic pull is in the track and verify the track unlock. Yeah, this tells us that everything mechanical is intact. Now let's verify electrical. If you plug the motor back in and push the seat back up and press the easy entry button, you can now verify that the motor runs too. Yeah, you can see it and hear it. Here we can see that everything electrical is working well. This is Tesla's online parts catalog. In our case, we need part 6, the easy entry track release actuator assembly. It's the actuator and the cable. Ordering parts from Tesla is incredibly clunky. As of June 2024, you do it by making a service appointment with other reason and providing the part number. Just Google how people have to do this. It's amazingly bad. Tesla, how about a parts ordering flow in the app, please? Anyway, here's the invoice for the $20 part. You will eventually get it. And here it is, all bright and shiny. So let's get this thing installed. First, we need to remove the old part. We just unplug the motor and remove 2 screws. Then we pop the cable off of the cable assembly and remove the plastic puller from the cable end. Removal is really quick. Before we put the new one in, we're gonna need to take care of this. With this breakage, this is really loose. We're gonna need to stabilize this. There's a lot of force on this cable assembly. I'm just gonna use two strong zip ties to take care of this. By the way, I'm making this video because my first video about fixing Tesla's stuck reclined seats seems to have helped a lot of people. I'm gonna try making a few more videos and based on response, maybe continue. I discovered that if I remind you to like and subscribe, that it roughly doubles likes and subscribes. So if this content is useful or enjoyable, please like and subscribe. That's much better. The reinstall is just the reverse of the removal, but there is a trick. Getting the cable end into the plastic puller is really difficult. You really need a pair of curved needle nose pliers. First, make sure that you give as much length to the cable as possible. Every millimeter counts. Not here, here. Now you need to grab the cable behind the head and kind of trap it above the housing and place the plastic puller over the head. Now as you remove the pliers, allow the head to fall into the slot of the plastic puller. It looks easy in this video, but it takes a few minutes to get this figured out. Oh, by the way, on newer builds, apparently there's a metal clip here that helps retain that cable puller. Don't forget to remove and replace that too. Anyway, now you just seat the cable and the rest of this is easy. Plug it in, screw it down, put the back, zip it up. First, we'll test that the seat can latch and unlatch to the track and behaves properly with the manual slide release. Finally, we'll verify that the easy entry system is working properly. Seat folds halfway, track unlocks, seat can slide, seat relatches to the track, and the recline unlocks. Looks good. So Tesla, you've got to do better here. Please stop wasting seats and your customers' money.